I'm Rose Della, the Artistic Director and Principal of the Center for Indigenous Theatre. CIT is a post-secondary performing arts training center. We offer a 3- and 4-year full-time conservatory-style education. Our program is designed to connect theater training with traditional and contemporary Indigenous cultural practices to advance artistic development, industry and business practices, and ultimately to cultivate professional opportunities. You will come here to train, to learn, to grow, to become the emboldened and inspired voices of tomorrow, the new generation of passionate Indigenous culture creators. To tell your stories in your voice.
Nea Nehio. My name is Kitsune. I am the offspring of a residential school survivor. Many of the students here have similar stories where their parents, grandparents, and great-grandparents went to residential schools, where our culture, our language, and identity was stripped from us, our practices forbidden. Today I'm here to give thanks by doing a land acknowledgement and thanking the caretakers that came before us. But instead of doing a specific acknowledgement, I put down some tobacco today for you to have a safe journey and to enjoy the show. If you'd like to know whose land you're currently occupying, check out these two resources here. So whether you're here in Ontario, in Toronto like the students, or nationwide, giving thanks to those who came before us means that we are giving thanks to our ancestors and the many generations who came before us today.
Welcome to the Center for Indigenous Theatre's program info session. My name's Kai.
And my name is Kate, and we are part of the administrative team at CIT.
We're excited to be here today to talk about our school and how you can become a student.
Have you ever thought about becoming a star? Let us know in the comments below.
If you're watching us right now, you probably have some questions about the Center for Indigenous Theatre and what we're all about. We're here to answer those questions. We'll tell you a little history about CIT, what the program and school year would look like, what we do to keep you safe, as well as how to apply and get into our program.
During our video today, you also get a sneak peek of some of CIT's students' creations. Also, we were able to sit down with alumni Katsune Sole, so stay tuned. Let's start off with a quick history lesson. CIT was founded by James Bowler and was originally a 6-week program called Native Theatre School. The Native Theatre School was then renamed Center for Indigenous Theatre in 1994. We went on to become a full-time program in 1999. We then expanded to a 3-year program in 2002 and then added a 4th year in 2018.
If you're still wondering what CIT is really all about, the Center for Indigenous Theatre is a post-secondary program that provides training in acting, voice, and movement. We also offer cultural classes that are focused on dance, oral history, and song. We have partnerships across Canada that we're able to share experiences with throughout the year. Our students are immersed in land-based teachings with Dabajimajig storytellers in Manitowani and Onomatazi in Nipissing First Nation.
Now it's time for two special performances from our March 2021 showcase, featuring our first year students. Take a look.
Nature or nurture?
Hello, welcome back. I've got a little concept to dissect for you. Nature versus nurture. The great debate, after all. How much of our existential reality is based on our blood versus how much of our existential reality is based on how we were raised? Are we dreading the facts here? So if part of who we are is based on our genes versus how we were raised, our childhood traumas, all of that mixed together to make the perfect concoction known as you. But I don't do this topic much justice, so let's have a look at the very next episode. Mother and daughter relationships. This is gonna be a train wreck. Mom? Mom? There's a creep tart at the door.
Well, answer it.
I'm not answering for Lord devours your soul. So creepy.
Clementine, if you don't answer that door right now, so help me God, I'm gonna fly down those stairs and deliver and smack you upside the head. Oh, for God's sakes, it's just the mailman. Fine. Watch your tone with me, young lady.
Oh my God, is that what you're wearing to the mall? I thought I gave you money yesterday to go pick something nice out.
Yeah, you gave me money, all right. But then you took...
Yes, I told you to grab that money and go pick out something nice. Something nice. Anything nice. And here you are, dressed like Raggedy Ann. We're going pageant scouting today, Clementine. And you better take those braids out because you know they hate that cultural shit.
Wow. Okay.
I guess you don't remember, but last night you came home drunk and then you demanded to know where the money was. So I took you to the kitchen. I showed you where the money was and then you swiped it from my hands to go spend it on more booze. Don't you raise your voice to me, young lady.
Oh, man, I've got a headache. Anyway, it's fine. It's fine. It's fine. You know what? I'll go grab something from my closet. I'm going to have to pin it back because of your tiny frame, but oh, you know what? I've got just the thing. Isn't she sexy?
Ew. Mom, no. It's way too... It's too everything. I'm not wearing that.
Why? Because of all the lace or the shortcut?
Oh, don't be a prude, Clementine.
The crowd's gonna love you. You know, you could wear that cute little choker you've got on.
I don't want to wear that. I'll look trampy.
Are you saying that I look like a tramp when I wear this?
Well, are ya?
No!
You better not be. Clementine, don't be ungrateful. You know, here I am trying to help you to make something of your life. And all you can do is criticize. Look, if you want to play up the element of surprise, you gotta wear something that the other girls aren't wearing. This dress is gonna be the key. Besides, Clementine, you're starting to have something to show off. You're on the edge of womanhood.
Ew, no. I don't wanna wear that stupid dress and I don't wanna go to the stupid mall and be stared at by creep-tard pageant scouts.
It's not up for discussion, Clementine. Now you're wearing it. And you can stop with the hysterics.
You don't know how lucky you are. My mother never taught me a damn thing about allure or how to attract someone. You've got to stand out at the mall so that these pageant scouts will be begging you to enter. And this dress is gonna be key.
Oh, come on, Clementine. Don't sulk. It's not a good look on you.
Okay. You know what? If you wear this dress and behave yourself at the mall, I'll fix us up drinks tonight. We can play the music loud and just dance the night away. Even if you don't get picked, but honey, I know you will.
Fine.
But I get to pick the music this time and you can't complain. Deal. Deal. Don't worry. Mama's gonna go fix this up. Oh, my sweet little star.
What? You want me to entertain you? Like a child? Is that what you want from me, huh? What do I look like to you, a clown? Don't answer that. All right, all right. I could perhaps show you some magic tricks, huh? You like magic? Magic is good for your little soul. Well, have I got a trick for you? So, let me blow your little mind, eh? Well, you see, this whole time that I was smoking, what you did not realize is there's no smoke here. Huh? Huh? Amazing! How does he do it? We don't know, we don't know. Magicians, they never tell their secrets, huh? Oh, what? You don't like that? Huh. Well, have I got something in store for you? You don't like that, you're going to love this next trick. See this cup here? Regular cup, huh? Deceptively heavy. I will make this float before your very eyes. You'll be amazed, okay? I know you will like this trick. Don't worry, okay? Here we go. One, two, three. Abracadabra, kazam, and it's floating. Ah, pretty good, huh? Pretty good. Pretty amazing, girl. How does he do it? We do not know. Oh, you don't like that one either, huh? Well, let me try this one for you, huh? You see this water in this cup? Well, I, one of the most greatest magicians in the world, can make this water disappear. Before your amazement, huh? Are you ready? Okay, okay, okay. One, two, three, now you see it! Now you don't! Pretty amazing, no? How does he do it? We don't know. Oh, stop! You don't like that one either? Alright, alright, alright. Let me try to blow your mind one more time, okay? This one is the one. This one is good, it's good, it's good. For you see, some people were just born with the gift of telepathy. Such as me. So, for this trick, I'm going to read one of your dirty little minds. But don't worry, I won't reveal all of your secrets, eh? In order for this trick to work, I need you to think of one day of the week. Any day of the week between Tuesday and Thursday. Can I get a volunteer? You, sir, yes, yes, yes. So, per my instructions, I need you to think of one day of the week, any day of the week, between Tuesday and Thursday. You ready? You got it? Don't say anything! Don't say anything! Oh yes. Oh yes, I'm picking up strong vibes from you. Oh, you've got some secrets, huh? Okay. I got it! The day of the week that you are thinking of, it's Wednesday, no? Yes! Oh, perfect! Yes, yes, yes. Oh, come on, you don't like that one either. All right, all right. For my last one, I will vanish before your very eyes. This trick, very dangerous. I need all of my concentration, otherwise I could disappear forever. I'm sure some of you want that, but for me, not such a good idea. Okay, So, here we go. Are you ready for magic, ladies and gentlemen? I will disappear before your very eyes in 1, 2, 3. Oh, look over there! What's over there? Ta-da! I am gone!
Now it's time. That showcase was definitely something not to miss. What did you think, Kate?
I loved it. We have a lot of talented students coming through CIT. Feel free to check out the rest of the showcase on our YouTube channel.
Want to know what the school year might look like? The next cohort of first-year students will start school in September. They will begin an orientation period of CIT in Toronto. And then students will enter full-time training with a winter break in between their studies. Our first years will then continue training from January until May, leading up to graduation.
Due to COVID-19, CIT has special protocols that have been put into place. These include mandatory social distancing and facial coverings, as well as screening before entering CIT studios, sanitization of all props and surfaces, and the health and safety of our students, faculty, and staff members is utmost important to the CIT community. As they say in show business, the show must go on.
That probably leaves you thinking what your class schedule might look like this upcoming school year. As our current health and safety regulations continue to develop, your training may be influenced by COVID-19. As you can see, this one of the schedules includes 100% in-person training, while the other schedule includes a mix of 60% online training and 40% in-person training. You have a variety of classes at CIT, including dance, voice, physical theater, singing, and story creation.
It's now time for our interview with alumni Kitsune Soleil. Enjoy.
Sure. My name is Kitsune Soleil. I am from Mistawas's First Nation. So I'm Bear Clan and Plains Cree. But I grew up in the Niagara region, and that's kind of where I'm based right now in Treaty 3.
What career have you been able to pursue since graduating from CIT?
Well, I didn't really pursue much like creative stuff because I've like jumped around. Like I went into like dog walking, which was like really fun. And right now I'm working in social media. So I've got like a media marketing agency. But aside from that, I have done like some small gigs and stuff like that with acting. And right now I'm like at the point in my life where like I keep being drawn to like doing something creative, and I keep finding like old books and stuff with like random bits of writing in it, and I'm like, oh, I'm so happy that I'm doing this again.
So just to go off of that, would you say one of your passions is writing?
Yes. I had like, well, not like a tiff or like anything like that, but I was kind of like in a mood because we had like our Christmas break or like whatever, where we had like a month off from like seeing my mentor and writing and whatnot. And not that I had gone through the script, but I was thinking of all the things that I had written up until that point. And it was kind of like very off of what I had wanted to write in the first place, because I wanted to like write about like the dangers of social media and like how that affects your persona and your perception of self and like whatnot. But like everything that we've worked on up until now has been like building like, I guess, like the bare bones of like the characters and like their universe and whatever. And then like our first meeting back, I was like kind of had it on the tip of my tongue where I was gonna tell Ed that I was like, oh, I don't know if I like this anymore. But like he didn't even know that I was coming at him with that conversation. He just like, he got me really pumped about it again. And then at the very end, I was like, oh, I'm glad that we had this conversation, because I was like very not into it. But then after that, like the week later, I've been delving into my writing again. I'm like, oh, this, I'm pretty good, I guess.
That's great. Are you writing a one-person show on like how social media affects you?
I'm not entirely sure how I want to frame it, but like I think it would be cool to like have like a one-woman show, because it's mostly just like centered around like one person and their universe and all the people around them. But then they've got like their online persona, and then like basically like the character, I guess, is like an influencer, but like her boyfriend is her manager, but he's like controlling and keeps her online to pay for the bills, and then he keeps taking more money from her or whatever. So she's just like stuck in this sort of realm.
God, it sounds intense. Did you make a lot of connections at CIT when you were here?
I'd say yes. I think that's another part that I really enjoyed about going CIT was like they're very focused about letting their students be involved in the community, or like not forcing us, but like bringing us out to shows. And like there's one time where we went for like a bit of a field trip to see King Lear, but it was kind of like, what's it called, like an adaptation where they kind of like made it sort of like indigenized and whatnot, as well as just like checking out like the local festivals like Imaginative and Musaikichuk, and those sort of festivals are around town. It was a great chance for us to like, you know, get exposed to other Indigenous artists and like what's out there, as well as like, you know, Imaginative is like film, right? And then Musaikichuk is like theater. So it was like a good balance that they had us like experience all the different kinds of medias and whatnot with like the community, as well as like lots of the teachers and people that they would have come in for like a workshop or whatever, just like building, like it's up to you really as an individual to like put yourself out there and make those connections with those people and like stay in contact with them. Or even I would go as far as saying like this current student body that you have, like keeping those connections strong, and then literally making your own works, right, is definitely something that would like help you out in this sort of field, but especially like relying on your peers to like make those kind of works and whatnot. So it definitely was a good place to like have those connections.
Kitsune is awesome. Thinking of applying? Let us know in the comments.
Hey Kai, do you want to hear a joke?
Sure, Kate, what's the joke?
Why are so many ghosts haunting the theaters?
Why?
They can't wait to boo the performance.
That's a good one, Kate. But don't you think theater jokes are a little staged? Are you still wondering if the Center for Indigenous Theater is right for you? Let's go over requirements needed in order to apply to CIT.
You must first identify as First Nation, Métis, or Inuit. You must be 18 years of age or older. You need to have a grade 10 English level or higher, have an interest in acting, movement, voice, self-discovery, and theater, as well as an interest in exploring Indigenous culture and knowledge.
Now that we've gone over the requirements, here are the important documents that you are expected or required to submit when applying. They include an updated resume, a 500-word essay expressing your interest in theater and coming to CIT, two references that can vouch for your interest in the arts, a photocopy of your health card, and an audition video of you doing some script work. To help you out, we've created a video on how to do an audition at CIT. Check it out.
Hi, I'm Sam Twin. I'm a fourth-year student here at Center for Indigenous Theatre.
Hi, I'm Teresa Cutknife, and I'm also a fourth-year student at the Center for Indigenous Theatre.
We'll give you some tips and tricks on how to do your monologues and get them sent into CIT.
Yes, so first find an age-appropriate monologue for yourself. Use something from the Indigenous canon, something like from Thompson Highway, Drew Hayden Taylor, Kenneth T. Williams, do you have any more?
Keith Barker, Alanis King. And if you have any troubles finding anything like that, you could email CIT and we'll provide you with a monologue.
So Sam, what did you do for your audition into CIT?
I did Isaac from Thunderstick by Kenneth Williams. What about you? What did you do?
I was sent a collection of different story pieces from Coyote City. What to wear? Wear something simple, neutral colors, something that you're comfortable and confident in.
Yep. And you know, it does. There's not really a time limit for it, but it should be around 3 minutes.
If you have any other skills that you want to show, like singing, dancing, hand drumming, anything and everything, feel free to submit it. But you do have to have a monologue.
Unless, of course, you're a storyteller and you have a story, then you could submit that instead of the monologue, but no accents, please.
And the most important thing is to have fun. And if you stumble, that's okay.
Yep.
You can do it over and over, as many times as you feel. Have any other difficulties like doing your monologue or audition?
Probably the hardest part was memorizing it all, and I had somebody film it for me. I did not know that it was best to film it with a neutral background, so I filmed it just in a living room, and there was a lot of things in the background, but it worked out. And you don't need a professional camera. We're doing this on an iPhone 10. You can stack it up on some books or put it on a table, whatever you got to do. As long as it's capturing basically from half of your torso up so we can see your shoulders and your head, you could have a relative or somebody hold the camera for you, and you could just send that in to CIT.
Have fun.
Throughout the year, we have ongoing requirements in order to remain in the program. Want to know how you can become a CIT grad? You are expected to be on time and present for all classes, and you must actively be looking for funding while you attend your studies. Tuition costs each year are $3,750. If you're unable to receive band funding, there are other organizations that you can submit applications to for funding. These include, but are not limited to, Inspire Foundation, Dreamcatcher Charitable Foundation, Métis Nation of Ontario, Canada Post, Mississaugas of the Credit, and other local organizations. If you are in need of application assistance, contact us at the Centre for Indigenous Theatre. No student is ever turned away due to lack of funding.
Hey Kate, what's your favorite part about working at CIT?
My favorite part about working at CIT is the community and the friendships that I've made. Everyone is so friendly and you feel like you're part of the family.
I love that.
What about you, Kai?
I like the performances. That's my favorite part. Mm-hmm. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram and Twitter and like us on Facebook. And make sure you check out our show, Bannock Republic, during the Toronto Fringe Festival. Running July 21st today to July 31st. For more information, check it out on our website.
We would like to thank our funders. With their generous support, we are able to provide a school for our students. The Department of Canadian Heritage, the Ontario Arts Council, the Toronto Arts Council, Ms. Waybeek Aboriginal Employment and Training, Hastings Park Foundations of Rights and Freedoms, Ontario Arts Foundation, and the Toronto Arts Foundation.
Thank you for attending our program info session. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. And we look forward to seeing you soon. Make sure you turn on our channel, our notifications for our channel, to catch our upcoming shows.
And applications are due August 15th. If you have any questions, please feel free to call or email us at CIT. We hope to see you next school year.
Bye. Bye.